Paper four is where we're going to start talking about now the movement of the actual dialogue, the movement of the voiceover, the narration, the words, in other words. The idea of number four is to get you to understand the concept of what I call, what was taught to me years ago, that I developed into what's called word whipping. Word whipping, as it says at the top of the paper, is the art of controlling groups of words like musical notes, changing tempos at will. So what you can do is you can think along the lines of every word or lyric, in our case words, in copy and scripts, having a value like a music note does on an instrument. So if it's a quarter note, if it's a half note, if it's an eighth note, if it's got two flags, it's a 16th note. If you've ever looked at sheet music, you know what I'm talking about. The idea of each word or lyric in a melody, if you're reading a music sheet, okay, having a value, it's the same as every word on the script that we're reading, having a musical or a timing value to it. Word stretching, the second component of the movement of the dialogue, is the art of dramatically elongating a word or a phrase to draw the attention of the consumer. If I want to stretch the word Stanley, I would go, Stanley was not a bad kid. By pulling on the word Stanley, I'm bringing your attention to that word by giving it more time or stretching the word, word stretching. It's used for dramatic purposes in reading. It's to give it a certain amount of emphasis on that word. Without hitting the word harder, I'm just stretching the word, which is called word stretching. The third part of it is natural stalls. Natural stalls is taking artistic freedom to add a short pause or beat within reads to create a better flow. What that means is when we're reading along and the author or the writer or the script writer or copywriter puts a comma, we should use that comma for a quick beat. Most people do what they do when they come to a stop at a stop sign. They roll through the intersection. And I'm guilty as charged. Many people don't come to a full stop, right? We slow down. If there's no cars coming, we roll through, and that's how we get tickets, a rolling stop, the cops call it. And I've had it happen to one of my kids, and it was an $80 rolling stop. A natural stall is not coming to a stop. That's a period mark. A comma, or adding another natural stall, what I call secondary natural stalls, is the ability to add secondary points within the read where you want to stall for dramatic purposes, stall for visual reasons, stall to give the consumer time to catch up with you, stall like for time.
What I just said, or are you listening to what I'm about to say?
Exactly right. Or stall for a purpose of letting a transition potentially happen. If you can anticipate there's a video appearing on the screen in front of them, you want to stall sometimes to give them a chance to watch it. For example, let's say there's a scene where you're reading a script and they don't have a comma there. The author didn't put a pause or a comma or even a semicolon or anything. And it says, as you notice in this footage, if it says, as you notice in this footage, the two cars collided at a high speed. Well, you probably know they're going to transition to footage there. So you should probably give the consumer an opportunity to watch it. If there's not a comma and you feel there needs to be a stall here, then you want to just put a little forward slash between the words is what I do. Okay. Once you get your page marked up and you've got your word whipping sections broken up, it almost makes it out to be chunks of bars of music in a way. The second thing you want to do is consider what words do I want to potentially dramatically stretch? And the way you can do that is by literally just pulling a line over a word. Take a pencil or your marker and just mark a line across the top of the word. That helps note where I'm going to stretch on a word. The third thing is where you want to do a natural stall is going to be pretty much the same place that you're going to do word whipping. Wherever you're going to put a word breakup is kind of going to be a stall point, a place where you will naturally want to stall in a different section of the read. Now, what will this do? And you're going to hear when I read test one for you, how dramatically it makes the difference when you deliver word whipping, word stretching, and natural stalls to a read. Here's how an average person would read this story. Stanley was not a bad kid. He was innocent of the crime for which he was convicted. He was just in the wrong place at the wrong time. It was all because of his no good, dirty, rotten, pig-stealing great-great-grandfather. Again, Stanley was not a bad kid. He was innocent of the crime for which he was convicted. He was just in the wrong place at the wrong time. It was all because of his no good, dirty, rotten, pig-stealing great-great-grandfather. Nothing going on. Very safe,
right.
Conservative read. Average voice talent would read it just that way. Here's how that piece would dramatically change, adding what I've written and what I've done here. Stanley was not a bad kid. He was innocent of the crime for which he was convicted. He was just in the wrong place at the wrong time. It was all because of his no good, dirty, rotten, pig-stealing great-great-grandfather. Now, which story would you listen to for another 2 hours? It's a no-brainer. The guy or gal who brings it to life versus the guy or gal who just reads it as it's written. The reality is, the whole idea is the rhythmic pattern change, the unpredictability is what will keep the consumer locked in. Hence, word whipping, word stretching, natural stalls. So you can move quicker and slower and speed up and slow down. So I can feel the movement, the tempo changes of the different pieces of dialogue. But yet it all flows as one continual type of piece, just adding those stalls, but moving different chunks with different rhythms. Does that make sense?
Yes.
All right, let's give it a go and see what you got here.
Stanley was not a bad kid. He was innocent of the crimes for which he was convicted. He was just in the wrong place at the wrong time. It was all because of his no good, dirty, rotten, pig-stealing great-great-grandfather.
You got it. Same thing. One more time. You got it now.
Stanley was not a bad kid. He was innocent of the crime for which he was convicted. He was just in the wrong place at the wrong time. It was all because of his no good, dirty, rotten, pig-stealing great-great-grandfather.
You got it. Much better. Now we're going to go through it and do the same thing. You're going to take advantage of the stalls. Every piece is going to have its own word whipping, but you're going to also now stretch on certain words here and there that you think feel like they need to be stretched on for dramatic purposes.
Okay.
So we're going to add the second component to it, the stretching of certain words.
Okay. Stanley was not a bad kid. He was innocent of the crime for which he was convicted. He was just in the wrong place at the wrong time. It was all because of his no good, dirty, rotten, pig-stealing great-great-grandfather.
Excellent. That was perfect. That was perfect. Now you're going to go through, and this time you're going to see if there's any other natural points where you think you can stall. We already have the ones in place. Let's see if you can find where you could put maybe another one or two natural secondary stalls somewhere in there. But keep everything else in place that you've done.
Okay.
And you can decide just by looking at it. If you had the paper printed, which I didn't let you have enough time, you could have put a little slash where you want. Yeah. But just try to think about where you
right now.
Yeah, think about where you might be able to just do one without having it printed and everything.
Okay. Stanley was not a bad kid. He was innocent for the crime for which he was convicted. He was just in the wrong place at the wrong time. It was all because of his no good, dirty, rotten, pig-stealing great-great-grandfather.
You got it.